Van St. John's interest in art began at an early age, inspired by a classmate.
Well, I started getting into art in third grade. My brothers and sisters and I, that one year, went to St. Joe's. While I was there, this boy was drawing a warrior and a horse, and I thought it was the greatest thing.
But like most skills any of us learn in life, drawing didn't come easy at first.
So I started drawing the warrior and horse, but it was like, I know it was disproportionate and wasn't even close to being right, but I kept at it. You know, it's just like anything else. The more you practice it, the better you're gonna get. So I started drawing it, just doing those whenever I could.
Van's dream of becoming an artist stayed with him throughout his school years. And it was even put on hold while he served his country. But that was only temporary.
Then when I got out of the military, when I was in, I just said I'll go back to school. But I got out and I bought some acrylic paper and paints and started in again, started painting. Then eventually went back to school and then took all the classes in it. For an art major, art education major, I had to take all these classes of different fields in art, you know, drawing 101, painting 101, design, photography, sculpture, jewelry.
After graduating, Van would put his education to work, teaching a new generation, and it's there where he found his next journey in art.
I went down to the Marty Indian School. I was there for 9 years, but when I was my second year there, I found out about the Northern Plains Tribe Art Trail. So the following year, I took some students on a field trip to go there that weekend, but it doesn't work out well when it's on a weekend like a Saturday. So I really didn't have a lot of students show up. So I thought, well, next year I'll come myself. So next year I went to myself, spent the day with the artist, talking to him, looking at all the artwork. Then the following year, I got in the show, so I was in the show. And I started doing all the shows, as many as I could while I'm still teaching, you know, still in the classroom.
While Van still hits the shows, he has transitioned to working with his daughter, getting his art out to the world through technology.
I don't really care to travel now, but I figure, well, I'll do the website, get that going, and then I could put my work in it when I'm retired here. When I give up teaching, I could do that. And then my daughter, I work with her. She's good with all that stuff, you know. She does the Venmo, PayPal. I don't know how to do all that. I could learn if somebody just showed me, and I was doing it a bit, you know, but I didn't bother. I figured I'm doing other things. She could do that anyway.
While Van typically works with canvas, he's also made his mark on a larger scale, giving back to his community in the process.
My first cousin called me up. He's the chairman down at Peter Linkick. And he said that they're gonna have Lyle Miller do this painting at the casino, on a casino fence there. So I was thinking maybe you could do something like some ledger horses on that fence in front of the commodity building. Well, yeah, I could do that. And I put the bright colors on it so when people see it, I thought, well, maybe it could brighten up their day. It's like at the time we lost a lot of people from COVID.
You can count on seeing original Van St. John pieces for many years to come.
It's like for me, to do the artwork, I'll do that all my life, you know. As long as I could do it, I'll just do my artwork. So it's like, because for me, it's fun, and it probably helps my blood pressure, you know.